if you see this program, like this is a basic HTML for understand by hosting in JavaScript. So hosting is default behavior of JavaScript. If you see here, I have given the definition. Hosting is a default behavior of JavaScript, where all the variables and functions declarations are moved on top. In simple words, we can say that hosting is a process in which, irrespective of where the variable and functions are declared, they are moved on top of scope. The scope can be both local and the global. So this is hosting in JavaScript, which is the default behavior of JavaScript, you can say. So we'll see here how it works and why it's important to understand. So let's refresh the page. So I refreshed the page and started loading the things. So if you see here, I have few functions defined in my JS file. If I go in my JS file, you can see here few functions are defined under this window load. Window load is my main method where the document will be loaded, and inside that I have written all these functions, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, so this window load, you can say this is as a closer also. So this will execute while the document page will load. So you can see here there is one method change background, which is definition is here, and change color of hashtag defined here, and this is being called here. And since this is one my function is there, and this is being called here, and one is my function too, and this is called here. So this is a temporal dead zone example I have written here, and this is also a bit of temporal dead zone example, where you can see like I have taken a variable a, which is given here, let a declaration is hosted here but remain uninitialized. This is uninitialized till now, and I'm trying to execute this a, will get reference error. It may be it will give reference error or it may not, because it depends on the browser engine how it's executing the code. So I'm printing this a here. So I think this will come under the temporal dead zone, and I'm initializing this a here, and this is the again console. I am printing the variable a. So above this line here, I have given in comment like above this line, above the initialization of the variable a, I have declared here like a and not initialized. So whatever the execution related with the variable a is will come under the temporal dead zone. So now moving forward, let's see how you can track. You can track the things by yourself by doing some console log and by doing some debugger. So let's see my application loads here. So this is loaded, and the first call here stops because this is an interpreter language. So this will interpret the statements whatever you have written here one by one from the top to bottom. The control will go from the top to bottom. So the first call will come under the change background color. So you can see in the local scope of this window, in the local scope of this window, these are the functions. Mm-hmm. This is the reference of the window, and the change background, change color of hashtag, my function two, and x. These are the local variables and methods for this scope. So you can see here, these are the local scope of this window. So the execution will start here, and I will move forward. You can see here, you can track by yourself. So step into next call function. So if I move, it came here for change background because this method is being called here. So it came here. You can see here one thing. Define the method below. The definition is before after the call, but it's not throwing any error like this method is not defined or so. It's because this is the default hosting property of the JavaScript. I'll declare anywhere and call from anywhere like that. So you can see here like it went for set timeout, and here you can see the local scope of this method change background method is this color, set the color. So moving to next, this execution completed. this execution completed or in the call stack. You can see here in the call stack you can see, because this is paused for 3 seconds, this is paused for three seconds, so it will be in call stack. As the time will cross, it will be removed from the call stack here. So moving to next, again you can see the local scope of this window are having these 6 things. So moving to next step, it came here for the change color of stack, and you can see here in call stack there are four methods. One is load, that was the primary, and these two are for the time limit. This one 300 millisecond. So it's again going in set timeout, and came down here on variable x. I have put the debugger here to track the thing how it's going to execute one by one. So after this call, it will come at line number 36, and after this, it will go for line number 44, and finally, it will return a value true. I'm just returning a value true. So moving forward, it came to my function. As I said, it came to my function. Next call, it came back in my function. Like this is function call, but the definition of this function is written here. So it's going inside this function. The current call is my function. In call stack, you can see the current function is my function, and call stack is my function. I'm moving forward. It came to console log A. Because this value is not defined, I have just let the value. If you put debugger here, it will not take. Like this is what we call this as temporal dead zone. A is undefined. So moving to next call, it came to A, and the next call is console.log. So now I have assigned one value and console.log, and once I click here, it will come here like return value is 0, because console.log never return a value. After print, console.log will not return any value. So moving to next, my function call is over now, and now I am here, some anonymous function call is still in stack. Because of this is not executed till now. I think this is also not executed till now. So moving to next, it came to A, try to change the color. Now it's come under the my function. So when I move for my function, you can see here I will put console here, and the first declaration happened here. Like I am declaring the A's declaration is hosted here but remain uninitialized. I will show here two examples. This is A and declared before the use, and one is used before the declaration. So in these two examples, you can see the difference how JavaScript hosting works, and how the const, var, and let are different, and how const let is different from var, how it's different from the var. So moving to next call, it came under console.log A. So A is not defined. A value is having nothing. So by default, whenever you put let A or let some variable, so by default, it will have undefined. It will not have any value. It will just initialize by undefined. So it's showing A as undefined. And now you can see I have assigned one string here. So everything above this line, before the initialization, once you declare the variable with let, and you haven't assigned anything, and you are just printing console.log, so everything above that assignment will comes under the temporal dead zone. Every execution before this line will come under the temporal dead zone. So moving to next, it printed the, now it have a value like hello. So it will print here. See, you can see here like this is showing undefined and defined like things. So if I step down and will go to next call, I think it should print here hello. Yeah, it printed here hello. So moving to next function, so I am in function 2 now. So A is used here, but it's not declared. A is being used or not declared yet. So I think it should throw reference error. So this thrown a reference error, like uncaught reference error, cannot access A before the initialization. So it's thrown reference error. You can see in the console log also uncaught at my function too. Let's move forward. What happens to next line? So this all executed once. First of all, whatever the method declaration are there and variable declaration at local scope are there, that will be hosted at top. And once all the things are fulfilled once, like declaration check and all, and after that it will start executing. You can see moving to next window initialize happened. So now this is set timeout, color is gray. Moving to next, change stack. Moving to next execution. So you can see in the call stack, this is my function too. Moving to next, it thrown me error, so it won't be executed, and it will directly, it enters here, it enters at this location and ask to load, ask the function if the document is loaded. Second, it execute this change background, so it execute this method, and when it is going to execute this method, it find like set timeout of 3 seconds. So it put this in call stack like with this timeout, with this time slip, and the next it come for this change color of face tag, and again it go inside this change color of face tag, and again it finds like set timeout. So it puts in the call stack. Now it move for var x, and this document get element set color style blue. So it, when it comes here, it's change the background, change the font color and all, and again it moves for the my function. When my function is called here, it go inside this block and do the things. Next it come for my function too, and it enters inside this, and it find like this A is being accessed before its initialization. So it throw an error and come out from here and go for return. But when it's going to return this load method, you can see the hosting of this JavaScript, like this function is, I have taken one reference like this change background function of type x and this one. So it's taken one copy like that. Moving to next, it's come in this change color of stack. Now moving to next, it come in set timeout. Now I am executing this var x, this document get element by id, and moving to next my function. So in call stack still it's not listed, because the control is currently at my function, but it's not going to execute my functions right now. When the execution will happen to my function, it will enter inside the my function block. In the call stack it will show like this. So moving next, and the my function execution will complete after this braces. So it printed hello till now. So moving to next at my function 2, and moving next in my function 2, it entered in my function 2 block call stack. So current call stack is at my function 2. It will show like this. I'm moving to next is thrown me error, so it directly come out from this, and you can see here like it again went, because this was in call stack. This was in call stack set timeout, and one method more is set timeout. These two are in call stack currently, so it will execute these two one by one. So it's executed and returned the value my final call, and return is here. So execution completes here. So this is how the hosting works, and here is one like the tempered dead zone. When you declare the variable with let and const, and you try to call it before initialization, so it this code execution will come under the temporal dead zone.